We know you're behind this, Q.
For one to fully comprehend this pony fascination, let me first...
What kind of twisted pleasure does it give you to bring terror into their lives?
Sum up the
millions of people down there who are watching as their moon falls out of the sky.
Previous of pony generations. Generation 1 appeared on TV in the 80s. It was made to sell toys. Plots were hardly very weighty. And Generation 2, I do not mean to...
Just as well, it would seem.
Grouse and gripe, but these characters fell right into the girly stereotypes. And Generation 3 is just too awful and too tragic.
You don't believe me, do you? Do you think I would humiliate myself like this?
If it served your purpose, yes.
So let's jump to number 4, where friendship is magic. All the characters compelling and the stellar storytelling and the lovely animation brought about great dedication.
You human as part of your punishment.
This is where we meet the bronies, for they like My Little Pony. Yes, the bros enjoy the ponies, so let's go and meet the bronies. Though the growth in pony fandom might simply seem absurd, true fans adore the show while others gallop to the herd. For hipster bronies watching Paso Ponies has appeal. So first it seems ironic, soon enough it's very real. For moderates, the start was humble, finding it through hype. When the